Or go into a car with hydraulics and go there, like, where the car lifts up and down, which I ate. Little mama, she back to the bone. I said, boy, what she do for her own? She ain't tryna hit, now she grown. Hit it once again, leave me alone. Little mama, she back to the bone. I said, boy, what she do for her own? She ain't tryna hit, now she grown. Gotta focus, I stay in my zone. Baby, you different like one of a kind. Swear I've been looking, it took me some time. And I'm in the studio, stuck on my grind. But he said, yo, what's going on, guys? Your boy Delay here, guys, and today we'll be doing another video. This video is actually going to be a story time. This story time is going to be about the first time meeting my ex's parents. Before we start this video, guys, I can't speak because look what time it is. Like, literally, it is 5:03 right now. I'm going to try to, like, pace myself when I talk and make it to where the story is more understandable and make it above 10 minutes. So, yeah, without further ado, guys, let's get into it. So, I got with my ex June of 2017, June 13 to be exact, if you guys want me to. Before I get into the story, I love her family. I respect them all. And there's things that I do kind of regret, like, after we broke up wise. Because, like, it's not like, hey, I want to get back with her or anything. But it's just, like, I still wish I was part of her life. And sometimes, honestly, it's good, too, that I'm not really talking to her. Because if I was still talking to her, I'd have a lot more love for her. And, like, I would still always have her on my mind and always want to be with her still. And, like, it's good that I decided to move myself away from it. And it's good that I've actually done a lot better since the breakup. And I'm happy now. So, starting off in this story. Her mom was always asking me if I can meet her during the summer. And me, I personally was too nervous and I kept throwing it off. And I know if you are watching this, I'm so, so sorry. It's just like, I was just too nervous to meet you and the whole family. Like, I know you guys, you're probably most likely watching this because I posted on my Instagram and I think you watch my Instagram story. But I'm very sorry I didn't meet you early enough. Like, I was literally with her for a while before I actually met her parents, if I guess I can say. And I made her a video that I don't ever show anybody, and it's off of YouTube now. And I would personally show you it, but I just restarted my computer. But it was like a love video, and I'm glad I actually don't have it, because, like, it's crazy to know that if you guys seen it right now, you guys would see the love side of me. And it's like, till this day, just thinking about it makes me kind of upset, but I'm not gonna talk about it, okay? It doesn't make me upset, it just makes me kind of miss the old time. But I'm not gonna say, like, oh, I wanna be with her still. Like, I mean, she was a good girl, and I respect everything she does, and I hope she moves on and finds somebody else, and I wish her the best. I don't want to be looking at her Instagram and stuff. And till this day, I've done really good at not looking at her stuff. When we get to school, and you know how there's homecoming and the homecoming football game for a whole lot of other people, me, I was, till this day, I do believe I was kind of a bad boyfriend. I never got one of them, like, little purple things that you put on your right here, I think, where it was that girls put on their wall, the girly things. I never got her one of them. I don't know what they're called. So I'm a bad boyfriend. I improved a lot, though. Like, a lot of girls tell me I look good and I'm good at pulling, and I'm not, like, to be honest, it's just there. Like, I just like being myself, and my nose is big, and I still get them. Like, I don't know how girls are always telling me I look good. Yeah, that's not part of the story. So one day, which is the game of the football homecoming game, whatever that is, I have to go get a haircut. I leave to go get a haircut at 3 because I do plan to go to the football game with her and her mom and her sister and everybody in her family. I plan to go. I went to go get a haircut after school, and she had driving classes. In Texas, you have to take driving classes to get your license, and I wonder if she has her license. She was in driving school. I wasn't. I was next door getting a haircut at the barbershop from one of the best barbers ever. That football game night, I'm getting a haircut. See her walk into driving school like an hour into me getting a haircut. Barbers, I respect them because they take forever when they do your hair. Like, my hair now is a bowl cut because I went from whatever I used to have to going my hair down, and then it's a perm now, and it's not as much of a perm as it was. I plan to probably do it again. So after I get my haircut, I walk outside, and that same night, I remember I walked to go to the restroom inside next door in the driving place, and her driving instructor went off on me, because I don't know, I guess I made him mad. He said it was a privately owned, but I needed to pee. He's like, you walked to Taco Bell. I was like, okay, I'm sorry. Needed to pee. Thought it was public. Don't unlock your doors if you have a problem. Stupid bum. Her mom pulls up to pick her up from driving school, and I literally walk up to her mom's window. Please, 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 please take me to the homecoming game with your daughter tonight. And my mom don't have to take me. She's like, my mom and her mom were probably, I think they were thinking something like, only an hour left. Why do you want to go? There's no time to go. But we wanted to make it happen. And a lot of people do believe that our fate is going to be to go together after high school year. After senior year, I mean. A lot of people think we're going to be back together. I don't want to look forward to something that you never know, okay? And if it does, that's crazy. That's crazy. That day, I think that was one of the first times I ever actually met her mom. Like, actually met her mom. So then, the next day rolls around. Me, look at me in this picture. I'm going to blur her out, my sister and her friends. But look at, I was wearing the ugliest outfit. I wouldn't want to be with me either. My mom takes me to her house, and I knock on her front door. Her aunt opens the door. I don't know why her aunt was all dressed up now that I think about it. Maybe she was. I don't remember. And I remember her mom was like, here, you can just sit on this sofa right here. I sat down, I see my ex walk down the stairs, and I was like, dang, she looks good. And it was the first day I ever met her mom. Her mom is really sweet, by the way. Whole family is sweet. They all still love me, I hope. Actually, it's whatever. So yeah, basically, I meet her mom. Her mom tells me I can sit down. He had a job at night or something like that, but I think he was there that night. So they gave us a choice to go into a van, drive to homecoming in a car with hydraulics and go there, like where the car lifts up and down, which I ate. Honestly, that car, just to make myself look nicer and funnier in front of her family, I was like, let's go in it. She didn't want to, which is funny, but I was like, hey, I'm finna go into it, because I was chilling, you know what I'm saying? I was down to go into it. But yeah, they were all laughing because we're in a car with hydraulics, obviously, which is funny. Back then, I used to dress really preppy, though, too. That is actually it for the story. I met her parents that night, and I want to do another story time about her. I want to give it a while. I want to do another story time about something else first. I do want to have a story time about my first kiss, too, and tell y'all about it. It was with the same girl, so there's also more of the story. That's the way I met her parents, and I hope they all love me, and I hope they all like, and I hope they enjoyed the 2 years I was there. And if you guys ever get into a relationship, anybody that is listening to me, treat the girl with respect. Don't you ever cheat on them. And on top of that, guys, make sure you guys show her family that you are worthy enough, and don't move away. And then, because moving away just ruins it, or if you move away, I'm gonna be honest with a lot of you, it's best to end it, because if you don't end it, you're just gonna get hurt in the long run, and they're gonna get hurt too, and it's something you both aren't gonna want to go through. My channel is gonna grow this year, though. Like, I'm going to hit 200 subs soon, and I do think I will hit 1,000 by the end of the year. And yeah, so yeah, guys, that is about it for the story. If you guys have enjoyed the story, drop a like, subscribe if you are new. If you guys want to see another video like this, make sure you guys tell me down below in the comments. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. It's been your boy Dolay here. No one can stop me, I feel like the greatest. Don't say be humble, I patiently waited. All of this love and I ain't even made it. I got a plan for them niggas that hate it.